prophet of mercy. Oh, my beloved prophet of mercy. Oh, my beloved prophet of mercy. Oh, my beloved prophet of mercy.
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen Wassalatu Wassalamu Ala Sayyidil Mursaleen Amma Ba'd Fa'a'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem Bismillahir Rahmanir Raheem Assalatu Wassalamu Alayka Ya Rasulallah Wa Ala Alika Wa Ashabika Ya Habiballah Assalatu Wassalamu Alayka Ya Nabiyallah Wa Ala Alika Wa Ashabika Ya Noorallah. Dear Islamic brothers, dear viewers and listeners of Madani channel, indeed, the celebration of the blessed birth of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam brings one a lot of joy, happiness and much reward in this dunya, this earthly life and in the hereafter. Also, by reciting large amounts of durood sharif, salawat and salutations upon the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will receive extra rewards inshallah ta'ala. There's a beautiful hadith, the summary of which, with reference to Al-Qawl Al-Badi', then our beloved Rasul, the owner of Jannah, the knower of the unseen, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, had mentioned that person who recites durood, salawat, or salutations upon me 50 times daily, I will shake hands with him on the day of judgment. Sallu ala al-Habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Salatu wa salaman alayka ya Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There was once a pious person by the name of Ibrahim, and he resided in Madinatul Munawwara. Zadahullahu sharafan wa ta'zima. He was a true and obedient slave of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. He would earn only halal rizq and sustenance, and would save half of his earnings for the celebration of the blessed birth of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. When the blessed month of Rabi'un Nur Sharif would arrive, he used to celebrate Miladun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very enthusiastically, abiding by the commandments of the Sharia, the Islamic sacred law. He would distribute a lot of food amongst the people as Isal al-Thawab for Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, and would subsidize his savings for any righteous cause. His wife was also a great obedient slave of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, and she would cooperate with her husband with heart and soul in this righteous deed of celebrating the blessed birth of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. After a few years, his wife had passed away, but he continued this act of celebrating Miladun Nabi sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. One day, Ibrahim called his son and he made a will. In this will he said, "My dear son, I will die tonight. I have 50 dirhams and 19 yards of cloth. Use this cloth for my shroud, for my coffin, and spend this money in any righteous deed." Having said that, he recited the Kalima Sharif, the article of faith, and his soul left his body. The son buried his father according to the will, but he was confused about spending this money that his father had left. When he slept at night, he dreamt that the day of judgment had occurred and everybody there was extremely frightened. The fortunate people, they were going towards Jannah, towards paradise, but the unfortunate ones, they were being dragged to hell, to Jahannam. He stood shivering with fear as to what his destination would be. Meanwhile, an announcement was heard that, "Let this young man enter Jannah." Therefore, he entered Jannah. Happily, he walked around, he wandered everywhere without any fear. After visiting all seven heavens, when he reached the door, the gate of the eighth heaven, he was told that only those who celebrated the blessed birth of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam in the world, in the dunya, they are allowed to enter into this Jannah. Upon hearing this, he imagined that my parents would be here as well. A voice was then heard, "Let this young man enter. His parents want to meet with him." Therefore, he went in and he saw his blessed mother sitting near the stream of Kawthar. Nearby, there was a throne on which an honorable lady was sitting. There were also some other chairs on which many venerable ladies, respected ladies, they were sitting as well. He asked an angel, "Who are these people?" That angel replied, "The one sitting on the throne is Sayyidatuna Fatima Zahra radiyallahu ta'ala anha. The other ladies on the chairs, they are Khadijatul Kubra, Aisha Siddiqa, Sayyidatuna Maryam, Asiya, Sarah, Hajra, Rabi'a, and Sayyidatuna Zubaydah radiyallahu ta'ala anhunna." He became very happy and continued walking and saw an even more faith-refreshing scene. He saw that a huge throne upon which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting. Around the throne there were four chairs upon which the Khulafa Rashideen, that is the four righteous Khalifas, they were sitting, alayhim ridwan. On the right hand side there were golden chairs upon which the Prophets alayhim salam, they were sitting, and on the left was the Shuhada, the martyrs, they were seated there. This young man, he saw his father Ibrahim amongst a crowd near Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibrahim, his father, hugged his son happily. The son asked, "My dear father, how did you attain this status?" Ibrahim replied, "Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, I have been blessed with this status because of celebrating the blessed birth of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam." That following morning, the son, he sold his house and arranged a feast using the money that he received from selling his house along with his father's 50 dirhams. He invited Islamic scholars and pious Muslims and he served them. As he was no longer interested in the dunya and the world, he decided to stay in a masjid and spend the rest of his 30 years worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal. Upon his death, somebody saw him in a dream and asked, "What has happened to you?" He replied, "With the blessings of celebrating the blessed birth of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, I have also received the same status which my father had received in Jannah." Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sheikh Abdul Haq Muhaddith Dehalvi has written in Mathabata bis Sunnah that those who rejoice on the night of the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam will enter into Jannatun Na'im by virtue of the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal. Muslims have always been celebrating the blessed birth of the beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam by cooking feasts, inviting guests, giving sadaqah and charities in abundance. They express their joy and happiness. They spend wholeheartedly their whole ijtima'at and gatherings and congregations for the celebration of the blessed birth of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. They decorate their houses and Allah Azza wa Jal showers His blessings upon them because of these blessed deeds. Sayyidina Abdul Wahid bin Ismail alayhi rahmatullahi al-jameel has stated that a great obedient slave of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam lived in Egypt. He used to celebrate the blessed birth of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam with much zeal and zest. A Jewish family lived in this neighborhood. When the month of Rabi'un Nur arrived, the Jewish woman asked her husband. "Why does our Muslim neighbor arrange such a big feast during this month?" Her husband replied, "In this month, the Muslims' Prophet, that is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was born. Therefore, he does so to celebrate his Prophet's birth. And Muslims, they honor this month a great deal. Upon hearing this, the wife said, "It is a nice thing that Muslims do by celebrating the birth of their Prophet every year." When the Jewish lady went to sleep at night, she dreamt a very graceful and magnificent saint was there, and there was a crowd of people around him. She stepped forward and asked somebody that who this person was. The other person replied, "He is the last prophet. He has come to meet and bless your neighbor for celebrating his birth." The Jewish woman then asked, "Will he, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, talk to me?" The person replied, "Yes, he would." The woman then called to the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, "Labbaik, I am here." Impressed by the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's reply, she said, "I am not a Muslim, and still you replied to me?" The beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Allah Azza wa Jal has told me, has informed me, that you are going to embrace Islam very soon." Upon hearing this, she spoke immediately that no doubt you are merciful and a courteous prophet. The one disobeying you will never succeed, and the one not believing in your lofty eminence will suffer loss. She then recited the Kalima Sharif, the Kalima Shahada, the article of faith, and embraced Islam. When she awoke, she embraced Islam wholeheartedly. She planned to spend all her savings in the celebration of the blessed birth of the Holy Prophet ﷺ by serving meals to the people in the morning. When she got up, she saw that her husband was also busy preparing some feast. She asked him in amazement, "What are you doing?" He replied, "I am making arrangements for a feast to celebrate your embracing of Islam." She asked, "How did you come to know about this?" And he replied, "Like you, I also beheld the beloved Prophet ﷺ in my dream last night, and I have also embraced Islam. May the blessings of Allah Azza wa Jal be upon him, and may we be forgiven for his sake without accountability. Ameen bijahin nabiyil ameen sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, Dawud Islami, which is a global non-political movement for the propagation of Quran and Sunnah, has a unique way of celebrating the blessed birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Huge ijtima'at, huge gatherings and congregations of Miladun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are held in many countries across the globe. For example, in Karachi itself, probably the biggest Miladun Nabi or Milad Ijtima of the world is carried out every year. These are extremely spiritual congregations which have invoked Madani revolutions, Islamic revolutions in the lives of thousands of sinners who have now adopted the perfect lifestyle of the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. May Allah Azza wa Jal also bless us, grant us the opportunities to get involved in the Madani activities of Dawud Islami, and also to celebrate wholeheartedly with joy, with happiness, the blessed birth of Aqa, our Master sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Ameen bijahin nabiyil ameen sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Prophet of mercy, oh my beloved Prophet of mercy, oh my beloved Prophet of mercy, oh my beloved Prophet of mercy.